Hey guys, this is Issues with Toddy Oneskip. I am Toddy Oneskip. Welcome to our channel, the place where we hang. Guys, where are you? Where are you today in this great big world? What are you eating? I'm ready to eat me some Chinese food. You thought I was just going to say Chinese and stop there, huh? Chinese food. Guys, I so appreciate you. There's almost 14,000. I keep saying that. But I have a feeling it's going to happen. Guys, I want to talk to you a little bit about Wade Wilson and his dad and Wade's wives. So Wade and his little peripherals. So as we know, Wade Wilson, for no reason, just no reason, unalive two women. He wasn't trying to steal a purse. He wasn't trying to steal a car. He just looked over at somebody and said, I wonder what that would feel like. I wonder if I could do that. What the fuck? Let me try. I don't know how that happens. He blames drugs. It seems like drugs bring out the very worst in him. But I've said you have to have something in you to bring it out, right? Something's got to be in you in order to get it out. Wade Wilson, you know, he was conceived by two teenagers. His biological dad was 15 years old, and the biological mom was 14. When Wade was born, Steve, his bio dad, was 16, and his bio mom was 15. And they tried the best that they could back then, as young as they were back then. And Steve, Wade's bio dad, he had his own demons to deal with. You know, he had been in prison. He had been in jail. He was not there all the time, but he loved his son as best as he could in his own little fucked up mind at 16 years old. And Wade was, from my understanding, adopted while Steve was doing a stint in the joint. And Wade was adopted by the maternal grandparents' friends that were church goers in the same church as Wade's bio mom's family went to. So he was never in the system. You know, sometimes we hear horrible things about people being in the system and how messed up they were. He was never in the system. He was loved. I've heard the interviews of his bio, of his adopted mom, Candy. He was loved. You know, maybe he felt like, you know, I think when every child is adopted, I think right away they're at a disadvantage because what we strive for most is our parents' acceptance, approval, our parents' love. That's what we do. That's what we strive for, right? And we can't help. And I don't know why. I don't know why we are designed to have the things that, and we might only hear things one time, you know, but why we are designed to let the things that hit us to the core cripple us. You know, I could get a million comments from you guys. You're so great, Toddy. You're funny, Toddy. This, I look forward to, and it means the world to me. And then I get that one comment that isn't so great. And that's the comment that sticks with me. But that's not just to me. That's the way we're designed. I don't understand that, but that is, right? So Wade Wilson, he wasn't rejected. I mean, if you had to look on it in black and white, yes, he was given up, but not because he wasn't loved. And it's hard because you can't see that. You don't want to hear that. There is no reason why somebody would not want their child because they didn't want him enough. And that's what it comes down to. They weren't wanted enough. For the fight for them, for the change of life for them. And they grow up saying, I wasn't asked to be born. I wasn't asked to be born. And right away, I was rejected. I wasn't important enough. Maybe that's what happened with Wade. Maybe. Maybe that's what happened. Whatever it is, drugs intensified it. And it seemed like when he was on drugs, it turned him into a different type of person. And that was meth, according to Mila, according to him, according to his dad and all that. Still, Wade Wilson is right where the fuck he belongs. Right where he belongs. So as we know, he admitted to this crime over and over again. And at every fucking turn with Wade Wilson, it's all about what he can get. His dad's trying to tell him, Wade, man, you're not a monster. You've done monstrous things, but you ain't a monster, son. Son, let's just tell the family where Diane Ruiz is. I mean, he didn't know the name at the time, I don't believe, but he was trying to, Steve, his adopted dad, who we know Wade got in touch with when Wade was 18, he got in touch with his bio dad and his bio mom, and they built a relationship. So there was 7 years of a relationship being built when Wade Wilson pulled his double M-U-R-D-E-R for no R-E-A-S-O-N. And so his dad's trying to get him to tell where Diane, where her remains are, so that her son can have some closure. So he's trying to appeal to his son's goodness, which he praises there. And as soon as Wade realizes, wait, there's something I can get out of this, seriously, he says, well, what's a lawyer going to do for me if I do this? This is Phone Calls from Prison, an excerpt from Phone Calls from Prison. Big shout out, Phone Calls from Prison! Yay!
I know you. I don't care what anybody says. You're so much like me in so many ways that I know you.
Yeah, I know.
And I know, mm-hmm. I know what, where you are mentally.
Yeah.
I know it. And I know that that's not you.
It's not. Okay? I know.
So anybody that knows you, knows that that's not you.
Yeah.
Everybody who knows you knows what makes you like that.
Yeah.
And that's the problem.
Yeah.
So for me, now, we I'm here, Ray, because I love you.
Yeah.
And I'm not going anywhere, okay?
Right.
The pain that you have caused, I can't even describe to you.
Yeah.
It's something that'll never be forgotten. So, you know, I talked to your mom.
Oh, did you?
Both of them.
Yeah. Oh, both of them?
Both of them.
Yeah.
And they both are heartbroken, son. Heartbroken. Your sisters?
Yeah.
I mean, that's what bothers me, okay? And listen, I want to ask you a serious question.
Yeah.
And I want you to be honest with me. Fuck all the other shit.
Yeah.
I want you to put your sister, put Whitney in this situation.
Yeah, I know.
What would you do, son? If that was your daughter, or that was your sister, or that was your mom, whatever. You already know what time it is. You already know that, because I know the love you have for her, especially.
Yeah.
Okay? And it's caused mass fucking destruction, son.
Yeah.
So, what's done is done. I don't know. I'm here to help you, okay?
Okay.
I'm here to help you 100%.
Yeah.
If I wasn't here to help you, I wouldn't have drove here for 3 hours. And I've been sitting up here for 2.5 hours waiting to see you.
Yeah, I know. Okay. I know that.
And I wouldn't have done that if I don't love you.
I know.
And I wouldn't have tried with you if I didn't love you.
Yeah.
But now, I went and talked to an attorney today.
Did you?
Yeah, this morning.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
But there's a few things, son, that have to happen. Okay.
Okay.
And only you can do that.
Yeah.
We gotta fix it. Because what you do under the influence of shit, when you lose your mind,
yeah,
that's one thing.
Yeah.
But you're sober now.
Yeah, I've had a lot of detectives try to come and talk to me.
I know.
Yeah.
I know that. But listen to me, son.
Yeah.
We gotta fix it.
Well, how do you want me to fix it?
We gotta fix it, son.
I think I know what you're talking about, but I don't know.
Listen, we gotta fix it, son. I'm here to help you fix it, because I'm gonna tell you why we gotta fix it. 3 reasons.
Yeah.
That 15-year-old boy that's missing his fucking mom right now.
Yeah.
Who is about to fucking lose his shit because he's waiting on his fucking mom to walk back in that door.
Yeah.
We gotta fix it. That that fiance who's waiting on
his
wife to come home. We gotta fix it.
Yeah.
And the only way, Wade, that you are gonna get any fucking leniency is to fix this shit. Okay? The first situation is what it is. You can't fix that. The damage is done. Okay? But there's one thing with this situation that you can make things better.
Yeah.
Okay?
Alright.
And I'm here for you. I will be here step by step.
What's your attorney gonna do if I fix it? You gonna take my case?
Well, yeah. I mean, I gotta pay him.
Alright.
What do you mean?
Alright, I'll fix it, yeah.
He didn't even want to admit to the crime, even though he admitted to the crime, but he was willing to give it all up for cheeseburgers because he was hungry. I can't write this shit. I know it's funny when you look at it that way, and I could do comedy about it. Yo, man, I could do comedy about that. I'll tell you where there's another body has nothing to do with me either, and you bring me a Whopper. Let's try BK Lounge this time. You see?
But if you want to get over the climax, what time are you going?
8 o'clock. Oh, good, man. Yeah. Patriots aren't even playing. We're fine. Are you going to fall asleep on me?
I'm eager for this French fries.
You see, but there's two unalived women, and there's a bunch of women that are stupid enough to now be in the wake of spending a lot of money. Now they're online professing their love to a guy that basically has a fucking sticky note on the wall with the person's name that he's talking to at that moment so that he can get the fucking name right of the person he's on the phone with. And then as soon as he hangs up with that person, he takes another person's name that he's talking to, writes it, puts it fucking right up in front of him, and baby, 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 and then peppers in that person's name on occasion to make it seem like he remembers who he's talking to, but there's a note right there with the person's name. I bet you. Because there's been how many Wade wives? How many times has he is a serial proposer. He's not, he don't want to marry any of these people or the men. He just wants the commissary. Give me that money, money, money. Sorry, Justin, I know it's from Yummy Yum, but he's buying it for Yummy Yummy Yummies. Commissary shit. So, you see what I'm saying? Wade Wilson is despicable. He admitted to crimes several times. We've heard it several times, and actually the same way, right? So, we've heard, not that we've heard different stories. We've heard one story several times the same way, which kind of tells us, there's some truth in that. Otherwise, he's got a really good memory for somebody that's effed up on drugs, yes? And his behavior and all of that shit, yes? He's already said, we've already heard now phone calls that have come out of the way he plays women, yes? Yes? And yet there's still more women waiting, W-A-D-I-N-G. See what I did there? Waiting for Wade. I believe that they're going after the GoFundMe because it wasn't used for what it was supposed to be used for. The person that actually was running it has, like, there's this huge drama saga over these women that just are fighting over a guy that is never going to see the light of day. Now, how fucking ridiculous is that? I just want to ask. And a guy whose heart is black as coal. It doesn't beat. Just asking, guys. Guys, I think that Steve has done everything in his power. He didn't owe his son to be an accessory to anything. His son put him in a horrible position. The only thing Wade Wilson cares about is Wade Wilson. At every turn, it's all about what he's going to get out of the deal. I'm kind of thinking maybe Steve sees it now, too. That the only time his Wade's ears went up, was when he saw a way for him to benefit from something and getting something. Guys, tell me what you think. And, Wade Wilson, piece of shit. Guys, this is Issues with Toddy Wunskip. I am Toddy Wunskip. Thank you, guys. I so appreciate you. Be better today than you were yesterday. Not half as good as you'll be tomorrow. Please like, subscribe, and share. If you don't like us, we'll let you leave. We are not a cult. We do not make you stay, and we do not offer Kool-Aid. That's the one beverage we don't offer. We offer everything else. All right, guys, take care. Bye.